Give me the headline. Where are the general areas that machine learning fails?
Overconfidence is one of them, which is obviously a danger in any security situation. So people believe machine learning will change the game for them, and that's an overconfidence problem. So in fact, it may change the game negatively rather than positively. We saw this with cloud too, where people thought cloud would be better. It can be, but it also can be worse. Performance and ease of use are some of the harbingers of success, and security often is opposed to those. Well, machine learning brings with it performance and ease of use, and of course security may not be in alignment with those other two. So you can actually go faster doing bad things, and it can be easier to do bad things, right? Which is no different than what we've seen in tech before, but now with machine learning, people have an overconfidence that the ease of use and the performance will somehow make them safer. It doesn't always.
All right, so let's talk about the categories of failure. You were talking about how you had mentioned earlier that, like, where there's been machine learning racism, actually, and that falls into multiple categories. Explain what the categories of machine learning failure are.
Well, to put it simply, there's sort of a hidden layer that goes on here, and there's a lot of trust that's put into this hidden layer, which is essentially that the learning systems are going to go and figure things out themselves, which doesn't require human intervention. The problem is within the hidden layer, they may be reinforcing bad traits of the past, and if you're not familiar enough with where you're coming from, it's hard to predict where you're going, which is true for a lot of situations in history. So as a historian, you look at the path that we've come from, and you say, well, if you apply machine learning to this, it's going to get really bad really fast. But people don't necessarily know where you come from, so they just assume, why wouldn't it get better? Driverless cars. Why wouldn't they stop killing pedestrians? Well, the real question is, why wouldn't they kill more pedestrians? And the data shows that we'd actually kill more people with driverless cars than less.
Give me a very specific example of a machine learning failure.
There's so many. That's one of the problems. I'm trying to talk about the top 10. So one very, very good example is you had Google launch an image recognition system, and it essentially didn't account for race. So while they tried to correct for whites, and they even had people at Google who corrected themselves looking at their own images, they never addressed it in terms of blacks. And so it was implicitly racist when they launched, because it started making blacks, it would classify them as animals as opposed to humans. Now, it also classified whites as animals and not humans, but they corrected that because they had whites working at Google. They didn't have blacks that looked at it to correct it for blacks. So it was racist in its initial state because the people who were tuning it, if you will, to correct it weren't accounting for race. So, and that's based in history. We've had the same problem with film. So it's not like this came out of nowhere. We've seen it also in the way that we address recidivism. People have used machine learning to try to figure out who would be most likely to commit a crime in the future. Well, we have a racist past in how we've dealt with justice in America. And so naturally, it had a horrible track record in predicting who would be recidivists in the future. It was 40% incorrect, a massive failure of machine learning.
What are, I guess, maybe your top two or three pieces of advice on how to avoid having a machine learning failure? What are things to look out for, I guess?
Well, this is sort of the secret sauce of the presentation, is that for 7 years I've been working on a book about how to fix this problem, and I started with the technical aspects, the controls, because that's what we do in information security, is we figure out controls, firewalls, if you will, and then we build a big conference around selling people on these controls. But ultimately what we're missing in the machine learning space is an ethical model that's really governance-based, which is, when are you doing something which is unsafe or is going to harm people? And we saw this with Facebook in particular. Their lack of ethics allowed them to actually create situations where people were being murdered, close to genocide, and I think that's the core issue here. If we can't regulate the information flow and we are using machine learning to generate huge amounts of harm, then we have a much bigger issue than just a control space. It's not about RBAC, it's not about IDS, it's really about what is safe, what's unsafe, and who gets to decide what information is harmful to prevent it from flowing.